See, enter into his gates with thanksgiving and unto his court with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. That's when you come in those doors, you'll think about Jesus. Think about the price that he paid for you, for your sin on the hill called Calvary. You don't need to go to hell, what I'm trying to say. You don't need to go to hell. If you go there, it's at your own expense, at your own will. You don't have to go to hell. The price. The reason why we're here today is because Jesus paid the price. The reason why we're worshiping today is because he paid the price. That we can worship the Father in spirit and in truth. He said, for the Father seeketh such to worship him. You cannot worship God unless you have the right spirit within you. I need not ask you whether or not you have the right spirit in you. You can determine that for yourself. As to what kind of spirit you have within you right now. If you can't worship, you don't have the right spirit. If you cannot worship God, you do not have the right spirit within you. This is a house of worship. We come here not to praise Reverend Monroe, not to praise one another, but to give him homage. Give him praise. Give him adoration. Nobody have to tell you to praise God if you love it, if you know him. Nobody have to say, come on, let's praise the Lord. If you got something on the inside, it'll show up on the outside. But you got to have it on the inside. Before it can show up I'm looking at you. Before it can show up on the outside, it first got to be on the inside. When you have been born again, something happened to you on the inside, and it radiates on the outside. You can look at your expression and see that a change has been made. Somebody say a great change. When you come in these doors, you ought to be happy. Nobody ought not have to make you happy. But because God been good to you. He given you life, health and strength, activities of your limbs, brought you from a mighty long way by his grace and by his mercy. Nobody but God. I don't know about you, but I'm glad about it. Yeah, he been good to me. And he brought me from a mighty long way. Thank God for Jesus, who paid the price way back on Calvary. Over 2,000 years ago, he died. How many of you know he died? How many believe that he died on Calvary? So glad I heard my mother say that dying wasn't all. Yeah. I'm glad he died, but I'm glad that dying wasn't all. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. He died, but I'm glad he didn't stay dead. Yeah, he stayed in the grave 3 days and three nights. But early, somebody say early, 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 just one Sunday morning, he got up, oh glory, got up out of the grave. The Bible said, look back at the grave and said, oh grave, where's your victory? Oh death, where's thy sting? So glad, the Bible said, when he got up, he taken the victory from the grave. He taken the sting out of death. That's why they sing a song. Can't no grave hold his old body down. One of these old days, you're gonna lay this old body in a cold, lonesome grave. But I'm so glad, can't no grave hold his old body down. Yeah, Jesus rose early one Sunday morning, and because he got up, these days, I'll get up. Yeah, I'll get up. through a divine transformation. I'll get up, I'll pull off this old mortal body and put on immortality. I'll pull off this old terrestrial body, yeah, and I'll be chained, yeah, from this old creature that I am. So glad that Jesus, he died on Calvary for your sins and my sin. The reason why he died, is to pay the debt for you and pay the debt for me. What you call the redemptive price. You had to be bought back. Yeah, and nothing but the blood could buy you back. Yeah, justice required blood. Justice required pure blood. Not lamb blood, not bullock blood, but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can wash me white as snow? Nothing but the blood. So glad he died on Calvary. Yeah, yeah. He didn't just die. He just stayed there in Joseph's new tomb for 3 days and three nights. But early, 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 one Sunday morning, on the first day of the week, the Bible said he got up. He got up. He got up with all power in his hand, both heaven and earth in his hand. Jesus rose. He rose with all power. He rose with all power. You know, the soldiers that were placed at Jesus' tomb, they were put there to see that he wouldn't rise. They sealed up the tomb. They sealed it up. But you remember that old deceiver. They called Jesus a deceiver. Remember, he said he's going to rise in 3 days. They said, we don't believe it. We don't believe he's going to rise, but we better put some guards there just in case. We don't believe he's going to rise, but his disciples may come by night and steal his body away and then tell the world that he's risen. But we don't believe that. So we're going to put some guards there. They guarded Jesus' tomb all night and all day for 3 days and three nights. But they couldn't keep him from rising. He got up. Yeah. First day of the week. Am I right about it? Mary Magdalene. Yeah. And Salome. They went to the tomb to anoint his body with sweet smelling spices on the first day of the week. But when they got there, Jesus wasn't there. He got up out of the grave. He said, you can tear this old body down. You can destroy this body, but in 3 days, I'll raise it up again. Didn't he do it? So glad he did. I'm glad that he got up early on the first day of the week. I know he got up. They said, Peter, when Mary told Peter that Jesus had risen from the dead. Yeah, Mary told Peter and John, and they ran, the Bible said, they ran to the tomb, looked in, but they didn't see nobody. They didn't see Jesus. Yeah, John was a young man. He outran Peter. So John got there first And he looked into the tomb and he didn't see nobody and he stepped back out. But the Bible said Peter didn't only look in, but Peter went in, yeah, and investigated, yeah, the tomb. And Peter found out that he wasn't there. I know he's not there. And 30 years ago, I went to Jerusalem. I went to Golgotha's Hill. And my guide told me where Jesus was laid, where his tomb was. I got a chance to look at the tomb, but I'm like Peter. I didn't just look at it. I went into the grave. I went into the tomb. I looked at the headstone, but wasn't no head there. I looked at the footstone, but it wasn't no foot there. I looked at the pod where the body was lying, but it wasn't nobody there. I come to tell you, he rose. Really, really, he rose. He kept on rising. Yeah, he's still rising today. He's rising in the heart of men. One day, he rose. Yeah, he rose one day in my heart. And ever since that day, I've been trying to tell somebody that Jesus. Been trying to tell somebody that Jesus, he's alive. Aren't you glad that he's alive? Yeah. You may not be able to see him with the physical eye, but you ought to be able to see him with your physical, spiritual eye. You ought to be able to feel the Spirit of God moving in your heart. Yeah. But you got to be, you must be born again to feel his power waking on the inside. I'm so glad that Jesus rose, and he rose early on Sunday morning. He got up with all power. He paid the redemptive price in full. You have been set free. You don't have to go to hell. But if you don't have love in your heart for your fellow man, you're on your way to hell. If you don't have the joy of the Lord in your heart, you're on your way to hell. How many of y'all believe that? Amen. If you don't have it, then it's time for you to seek Jesus.